Hi guys, welcome to Naresh IT. This is Sudhakar and today we are going to discuss about cursors in T-SQL language in SQL Server database. Okay, let us see. So, cursors in T-SQL language. Okay, so basically cursor what exactly? Okay, and who will create this cursors? What types of cursors are there? And why we need create this cursor, okay, in database servers or database memories? Okay, what is the reason behind this? So if I want to know these all the things, first of all we have to define what exactly cursor. Okay, we are going to defining now. So cursor is a temporary memory. Cursor is a temporary memory, or else we can say it is a temporary work, or else we can say it is a temporary work station, or else temporary work station. Okay, so this is what we can say, cursor is a temporary memory or it is a temporary work station we called here, and this memory is going to created or else allocated. Okay, it will allocate by database server. Okay, database server at the time of DML operations, at the time of DML operations are performed by user on database tables. Okay, so this is what we can say. So cursor is a temporary memory location, or it's called as a temporary workstation also we can call. Okay, and this memory allocated by database server at the time of DML operations are performing by user on database tables. Okay, so at the time automatically the server will allocating some memory, and this memory is called as a cursor. Okay, and this cursor memory, why we need to allocate, why it was allocated, means simply I can say for storing database tables, for storing what now, database tables. Okay, we can simply call that here. But why we need to store database tables in cursor memory, that we will see it here in the examples. Okay, now so this is what simple I can define what exactly cursor and how memory is allocated. But these cursors are, again the people was divided into some types here, so that is we called as a types of cursors. Here two types of cursors are there. One is we called as implicit cursors is my first one. Okay, and the second one we called as a explicit cursors. Okay, is my second one. Okay, so what is the mean by implicit and explicit means? Okay, let us see now. The first we are going to discuss about definitions here. Okay, first what is here, implicit cursors are called a default, these are called a default cursors of SQL server, is a default cursors of SQL server database. Okay, SQL Server database. Okay, it is a default cursors of SQL Server database, and these cursors are this cursor memory. Okay, this cursor memory is allocated by database server. Okay, so but when I already said to you, when we perform DML operations. Okay, when you perform DML operations, so at the time of DML operations it will be allocating some memory. So this is what your implicit cursors we can call as. Okay, but whereas come to explicit cursors. Okay, explicit cursors what exactly means, these cursors are created by user. So whenever the user is created, okay, cursors are created by user. created by user as per the user requirement. So whenever the user wanted its to own cursor memory, if I want to create my own memory in a server side location, there I am using what now, explicit cursors here. And explicit cursors, the main intention is what now means I want to fetching my data, fetch data from table in row by row manner, in row by row manner. Okay, so whenever you want to fetch the data from the table in row by row or record by record manner, then you must and should be create what now, explicit cursors. Okay, so this is what we required. And explicit cursors are mainly intention, the main purpose of explicit cursor is row by row manner fetching purpose. But how to create these explicit cursors means, if whenever I want to create or whenever I want to work, okay, so I work with, okay, whenever we want to work with explicit cursors, okay, we need to follow the following 5 steps I need to follow here. Okay, I need to follow the following 5 steps here. What are the steps here? I will show you one by one. And now come back here. My step 1, okay, what is the step 1 here? Declare cursor object is my first step. Declaring or declare cursor object. And second step number 2, open cursor connection. Open your cursor connection is my second step. And later the third step we called as a fetch data from cursor is my third step. Okay, and after that, after fetching the data from your cursor table or cursor memory, then step number 4, what I want to do now, I just close my cursor connection. Okay, close my cursor connection. And finally step number 5, deallocate cursor memory. Okay, deallocate cursor memory. So these are what we called the 5 steps of cursors, and these 5 steps I should follow only whenever the user is working with the explicit cursors. So then only I can use these 5 steps, but other than explicit cursors we can't use any other cursors. Okay, so these are the 5 steps. And now these 5 steps how to follow. Okay, what is the syntax? That means if I want to declare my object, how we are going to declaring. Okay, so that is what. And later how to open, how to fetch, and how to close, and how to deallocate. So along with these steps I will give some syntaxes here, how to create your cursor object. Okay, the first step syntax I just follow now. Okay, so my syntax is, okay, declared, I want to send here my cursor name, I want to send first of all. And later cursor is a predefined keyword for, and here I am going to writing select star from table name, it's my query. So it's my first request and first statement, the declaration of cursor object. After allocating the cursor or creating the cursor memory, then what is happening here, that memory connection should be open. So how we can go to open means, we have a syntax here, open, and I just follow here cursor connection. I just follow here cursor connection. It's my second step. And come to third step. When come to third step, what is my third step here? Fetching data from cursor. Okay, so now I just follow the syntax here. Okay, how to fetch means, here I'm using fetch statement. So fetch, I'm using some methods here, these are called the fetching methods. Next method, or else first method, or else last method, or else prior method, or else absolute method, absolute end method, okay, or else relative end method, okay, relative end, from I want to send here my cursor name. And whenever you want to create your cursor or fetching your data from the cursor memory along with your cursor variables, then there I can use this into variables I want to use. into variables. But this into variables I can use whenever you want to working with the variables, otherwise don't use it. And your next, first, last, prior, absolute, relative, these are called a fetching methods of cursor, fetching methods of cursor. Okay, so that means next means what? Now I want to fetch my rows in one by one manner, forward directionally. Okay, first means first row fetching from the cursor table. In the same to same, last record, prior, previous records in previous directional, otherwise we can say backward directional. Absolute means exactly position of the record. Next, relative means either incremental manner or decremental manner we are going to fetching the data. And last one is what now? So relative n is increment or decrement from your cursor. And into variable is an optional way, and when you're using variables in the cursor, then only use it. Okay, this is my step number 3. And step number 4, what is the step number 4 here? Close your cursor connection. So we have a syntax is there. Okay, how to close? I'm using close keyword, and same cursor name I want to pass it. After closing your cursor, then you just follow deallocating cursor memory. So deallocating cursor memory, now I can deallocate now. So deallocate keyword I'm using, deallocate, and here I just send my cursor name. I want to send my cursor name. So these are the steps, okay, one by one steps here. The step 1, declaring cursor object. Okay, declared cursor name, cursor for select star from EMP. And later, second, open your cursor connectivity or connection. And later you can fetch data from the cursor. So I'm using some methods here, and close cursor connection. Okay, and later fetch data and close cursor connection, later deallocating memory. So these are what now the steps, okay, we are going to use whenever you want to work with explicit cursors. But these steps, these 5 steps, how to use in my cursor program, okay, that we will see in the next video session. Thank you for watching this video.